Now let's discuss the school summary of immunization status, otherwise known as the 45-day report. This summary is completed by school nurses. The DHEC 1124, School Summary of Immunization Status, has recently been revised. The purpose of this form is to assess schools' compliance with the immunization requirements and reporting requirements as set forth in Section 44-29-180 of the South Carolina Code of Laws and Regulation 61-8. This compliance assessment is reported to the South Carolina Department of Education for accreditation purposes. As we go through the couple of slides that explain how to fill out the form, you will see that the reporting required is hopefully easier to understand with this revision. School nurses complete this form and after the completion, send it to DHEC. This form is to be completed by the 45th calendar day from the first day of school. However, it should not be completed earlier than the week of the 45th day. It must be sent to your DHEC regional contact person within 7 calendar days after the 45th day. This form only applies to students in 5K through 12th grade. Please refer to the revised DHEC 1124 located under the 45-day report tab. The first part of the 45-day report is for documenting demographic information regarding your school and for naming a contact person that we may call if we have any questions about the report. Usually this is the school nurse. You will need to enter all the information regarding your school noted on this slide. In the next section of the form, you should enter the total number of students enrolled in grades 5K through 12 in your school that fall into each noted category. On line number 1, enter the total number of 5K through 12th grade students enrolled in your school. On line number 2, enter the total number of students with a valid South Carolina Certificate of Immunization. To be valid, the South Carolina Certificate of Immunization must include 1. The name and date of birth of the student, 2. The signature of the physician or authorized representative, and 3. If a certificate expiration date is documented, a non-expired certificate expiration date. The number entered in line number 2 should include students who are catching up. That is, students who are not yet up to date on their immunization requirements and the date when their next immunization is due is denoted on the certificate expires space. The number entered in line number 2 should also include those students whose certificate expires date is denoted as not applicable. That is, those students who currently have a South Carolina Certificate of Immunization, the DHEC 1148, and have met the immunization requirements for school. On line number 3, enter the total number of 5K through 12th grade students with a valid immunization certificate that indicates a medical exemption or medical contraindication to vaccination. Remember that for an immunization certificate to be valid, any documented expiration date must not be expired. So if the medical exemption is a temporary exemption, the expiration date of the medical exemption must not be expired. On line number 4, enter the total number of 5K through 12th grade students with a valid religious exemption. To be valid, the DHEC 1126 or South Carolina Certificate of Religious Exemption must include 1. The name and date of birth of the student, 2. The signature and printed name of the parent, guardian, or person in loco parentis, and 3. The date and signature of the notary public. On line number 5, enter the total number of 5K through 12th grade students with a special exemption. On line number 6, enter the total number of 5K through 12th grade students who have been suspended because they did not provide you with a valid immunization certificate. On line number 7, enter the sum total of lines 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. This total should equal the total number of 5K through 12th grade students that you entered on line number 1. The next section is to be completed by all schools that have students enrolled in five-year kindergarten. On line A, enter the total number of students enrolled in your school's five-year kindergarten. On line B, enter the number of 5K students who are enrolled with a valid immunization certificate. Line A and B may not be equal. The next section is to be completed by all schools that have students enrolled in seventh grade. With the TDAP requirement for seventh graders going into effect this school year, 2013-2014, DHEC would like to assess the compliance with this requirement. On line A, enter the number of students enrolled in seventh grade. On line B, enter the total number of seventh grade students with a valid immunization certificate that demonstrates a documented dose of Tdap vaccine administered on or after the seventh birthday. Lines A and B may not be equal. This report must be signed by the school administrator, principal, headmaster, or director. Remember, all children enrolled must have a South Carolina Certificate of Immunization, South Carolina Certificate of Religious Exemption, or a South Carolina Special Exemption Certificate in their file. And do not send any copies of the immunization certificate or exemption forms with the 45-day report. Beyond the 45-day report, school audits are conducted as well. School audits are done annually by DHEC staff. The Immunization Division does a random selection of schools, public and private, in each county. The school audit is based on the total number of students in the selected grade in each county. It consists of a review of all immunization certificates for the selected grade level in the identified schools to assess compliance with immunization requirements. The results of the audit will be provided back to the school and are reported to the South Carolina Department of Education as part of the accreditation process.